Good morning. We just completed a problem where we found the net force caused by three forces acting on a stuffed turtle. And what I'm going to do right now is show you that this, summing the forces, is vector addition.
Hey guys.
Hey, Bo.
Hi, Bo.
Flippin' physics.
If you didn't watch that lecture, I suggest that you do so before you try this one. Summing the forces is vector addition. For example, we can do tip-to-tail vector addition of the force of Ken plus the force of Jim plus the force of Chris. The force of Ken plus the force of Jim plus the force of Chris gives us the same net force vector we got when we summed the forces. We can even do tip-to-tail vector addition using the components of the force of Chris instead of the force of Chris. So the force of Ken plus the force of Jim plus the force of Chris in the x direction plus the force of Chris in the y direction gives us the same net force. Going back to using the force of Chris instead of its components, we can show that the order in which we add the vectors is irrelevant. So the force of Chris plus the force of Ken plus the force of Jim gives us the same net force. We can use another different order of the force of Jim plus the force of Ken plus the force of Chris, and it still gives us the same net force. We could even use a data table like we did when we first learned about vector addition. Add up all the components in the x direction to get the net force in the x direction. Add up all the components in the y direction to get the net force in the y direction. Because summing the forces is vector addition. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Of the firefly, but in the water and the night sky, there is something worth the surprise. But the sky is getting colder, I can almost taste the rain, and our hearts are getting older, it's getting tougher to see through your smile. Your